In this video, I'll be talking about equation of trajectory in projectile motion. So this is very important, equation of trajectory. So let us assume that we have a particle which has mass m and it is being thrown at certain velocity at an angle, let's say theta, right? Now, why we are interested in equation of trajectory? So first of all, understand what is equation of trajectory. Equation of trajectory is the locus of the points of path followed by the particle during its journey, right? So basically, suppose that if I take any random point, let's say it has coordinates x, y, and I'm assuming that this is the origin, okay? So this is of point P. Point P is having coordinates x, y, okay? So now our task is to find out the equation of trajectory such that we can obtain any random point at particular instant, right? And suppose if I draw the full path, it will be like this. And we know that this range, this is the range which is the horizontal distance covered by the particle during the journey. And of course, this time can be represented as time of flight, right? So now here, if I see the situation, then particle is having two velocities, two components of the velocities. Let's say these are the axes, x and y. So this will be ux and this will provide you uy, where ux is nothing else u cos theta, and uy is equal to u sin theta, right? Now you need to observe that there is acceleration, which is z, which is equal to ay. So ay is minus g if I take upward direction as positive direction, right? That means now we are interested in talking about this point. So if these coordinates are x and y, that means I can say here, this distance is going to be x. Which distance? Suppose this is O, this is A. So I can say that this distance OA is going to be x, right? Because of the coordinate points. And obviously vertical displacement is y. So I can say that PA is going to be y, right? Now what I can say here, I can say that I can utilize the equation of motion in vertical direction. Equation of motion in vertical direction. So what do I observe? Equation of motion is S is equal to ut plus half at square. But I'm talking in vertical direction, so I'm writing Sy is equal to Uy plus half At square. Let us assume we took random time t from point O to P. So time t is time taken by the particle in reaching to point O to P, right? This is the time taken. So here what I can say that Sy is going to be here y, because consideration I am taking, consider upward positive direction, right? So if you consider that, then you need to replace y as y is positive y. Uy you can write plus u sine theta into t. Now plus half into minus g, because g is in downward direction, and that would be t square. Let us say this is our equation number 1, right? Now this t is here a variable, so we want to remove this t. So how to remove this t? So what I can see here, I know that in horizontal direction, in horizontal direction, we know that there is no acceleration as ax is 0. So we can directly apply sx is equal to ux into t. Now we know that sx is nothing else x here, because in horizontal direction, how much displacement it has covered? It has covered sx displacement, which is x, right? And ux, as we know, this is u cos theta. So x will be simply here, t will be simply here, x upon u cos theta. So we obtained the variable t. Now we can put t is equal to x upon u cos theta in equation number 1, right? So if I do that, what will I achieve here? So let me write here, y will be is equal to u sine theta into t. T is x upon u cos theta, and I can remove this segment here, which I don't need right away. And this will be minus half into g into t. T will be is equal to x upon u cos theta. So now we can substitute it, and now we can remove this one, right? So now we can solve this thing for the final expression. So for the final expression, we will be going further. So this u and u is cancelled out. This is sin theta upon cos theta. We know that sin theta and cos theta will become tan theta, minus half g into, this will become u square upon u square cos square theta. So this is going to be the equation of trajectory here, right? So this is going to be the equation of trajectory. We obtained a very beautiful expression. So you can clearly see this is a parabolic function. We can compare also this equation with y is equal to ax plus bx square. You know that this is going to be a parabolic function. This is a quadratic type equation, right? And now we can eventually move ahead. What I can do here, I can take x tan theta common. So we will be achieving 1 minus g x square upon u square cos square theta. As I have taken x tan theta common, so x tan theta will be going in denominator, right? So I am trying to achieve a different format of equation of trajectory, which also helps us in certain type of questions, right? That's why I am doing this. So let me remove it. So now what I can see here, y is equal to, this is x tan theta. Now I can write 1 minus, so now here you can observe this x and x will be cancelled out. So this will be x upon, we can use this g in downwards direction, right? So here one 2 was also there, I left it. So this 2 will be there. So this will be 2 u square cos square theta. What I can see here, tan theta can be written as sin theta upon cos theta. And of course, this g was in numerator. I can write here this g in denominator like this, right? So here, what you can observe, this cos theta will finish this cos theta, right? So सो हियर वी कैन फाइंड एक्स टेन थीटा इंटू वन माइनस एक्स अपॉन, नाउ दिस यू स्क्वायर विल बी हियर, यू ऑब्जर्व दिस इज कॉस थीटा इंटू साइन थीटा इंटू टू, यू नो दैट साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू टू साइन थीटा एंड कॉस थीटा, परफेक्ट, सो दिस कैन बी रिटन एज साइन टू थीटा बाई जी. And what a beautiful relation I'm getting here. If you observe this point, you know this is going to be the range in normal projectile motion. Range is equal to u square sine 2 theta by g. So we can eventually substitute this value. And then we can obtain, this will be x tan theta 1 minus x divided by r. So this is also another equation of trajectories formula. So we got two expressions. These both are representing the equation of trajectory itself. Okay, so I must suggest you need to remember equation of trajectory in order to have the fast solution of your question in projectile motion. Okay.